A tasker variable is just a place where you can store a piece of text. Think of it as a named drawer. This particular drawer has a peculiar name of %var. All tasker variable names start with %. You can store a piece of text in this drawer and check it at any time. You can only store one piece of text at a time though. If you want to put another piece of text in it, you have to take out the other one first. You can do exactly this in Tasker. In a task, use a variable set action to set %var to some value and run the task. In the vars tab, you can see that this variable now has the expected value. Back in the task, you can check what value the variable has with a flash action. This is just like opening the drawer and peeking inside. As before, when you put another value in the variable, the old one has to come out. If you check again, the new value is now in the variable. Just like your furniture can have many drawers, Tasker can have many variables. Check out this %home drawer, where you can toggle the value between true and false. To do the same in Tasker, you first check the current value of the variable with the if action. If the value of %home is true, set it to false. Again, use the variable set action to do this. Make sure to drag this action into the correct place in the task. Otherwise, set it to true again. If you now run this, since the value wasn't true, it was actually nothing at all, %home is set to true. If you run it again, it's then set to false, then to true again, and so on. You can even create profiles that do different things depending on these variables. For example, you can quickly create a couple of profiles that do different things when %home is false and when it's true. Just as an example, let's flash the words "I'm home" when the %home variable is true, and "I'm away" when it's false. Now, when the variable changes, the appropriate messages show up on the screen. If you want to know more about creating profiles or tasks, check out the links in the video description. Also, a quick note, variables with at least one uppercase letter in their name will be available everywhere. Variables with only lowercase letters will only be available in the task where they were created. That's it! If you ever get confused on what a variable is, just remember, it's a drawer where you can store a piece of text in it. Easy, right?